no, sustain Bruno, sabi dito, no, yung na-line up ng Blacklist International. Because if you come to think of it, talagang super sustain yung kanilang team. Well, Esmeralda, Alice, and syempre yung ating national ambulansya pagdating dito sa Land of Dawn, Estes ni Lady Senyorita. Si Lady Senyorita pa or si Madam Venus yung gagamit. And way back ano pa yan, season 4, di ba? Estes Lord or Estes Goddess. Pero kaya na guys, game number 2 na tayo ng Blacklist International against Sex Free Esports. Arasa na kaagad. On to that middle lane. Yeah, we have an HPL ready.
Oo, oh, nagkatadya ka na agad dito ng bola-bola. Eh, talagang nagpapasahan na nga lang sila. Ito yung kanina pa natin sinasabi na dapat they should have the higher or the early momentum for our next play esports. Pero ito na nga tingnan mo, oh, another setup sa bago. Si Aeson, kanina pa sila galit dito kay Aeson. Ikaw yung nagpahirap sa buhay namin kanina. Pero tingnan mo nga naman si Doggy, medyo napulahan siya. Kaya magbaback na lang siya muna. But all of the members of Next Play Esports, andito sila banda sa middle lane. Tingnan mo nga naman, Bae.
Yes, gustong-gustong gawin dito ng Next Way Esports yung ginawa sa kanila kanina na Blacklist International, which is to delay the jungle camp of the enemy team. But sadly, masyadong protektado yung Bruno natin with the help of SS and Paquito. Dahiling galing, help them sustain the jungle camp and not back away. And as of now, both of the team natin dito still are focusing on their own camps as well as yung ating Brody na on the top lane na. Whilst dito naman sa may middle lane, wala rin tayo masyadong harasan na nakikita. Focus-focus lang sa pakiramdaman dito sa each area.
Pinapakiramdaman nila kung bilog na nga ba yung buwan. Pero ito na nga, down bottom, Edward together with Grenadine, naglilingkisan lang. Pero ito, may dalaw, may pagdalaw dito sa may top lane. Pero naamoy, naamoy agad sila ni Chester. Sabi, teka lang, mamaya na muna. Dapat hindi muna narekta. Pero ito na nga, Bema, seems like he's up for another setup. Gantong-ganto siya nung nagdigi kanina.
Yes, nako, pero eto, look at this, the turtle is now up for grabs, it is waiting to be taken, pero Yawi yata, nako, with the forced flicker, this might be a good opportunity for the Blacklist International with this turtle, pero oh my god, if you actually look at this, 5 members ng next play, ang nakabantay dito, at may end possible team fight.
Grabe, nilima nila, 5v4 situation, pero ito si Chester with the blood, pumasok na natin sa gitna, pero ultimate pocket out, from our SS, pero yun ang nakapatay pa, first
shot,
secure by Yawi, pero ito na, falling Sarmon, yes, it did connect. Kaso yun nga lang, tamang disengage sila muna. So yun, nakuha. Sino nakakuha ng turtle, Bema?
Nakuha ng next play esports yung turtle and nakadalawa pa sila on that very last team fight. So sila ngayon yung may kalamagan dito sa ating laban. Ang ganda ng positioning ng limang miyembro dito ng next play esports. Questionable para sa akin yung ginawa ng Blacklist. No? Kasi they know na lima yung kalaban nila but they still tried to initiate a team fight. Hindi na lang nila binigay yung turtle side. Luckily though, hindi si Bruno yung napani sila and nakakuha pa yung Bruno. So hindi siya ganun kabad. Pero sa top lane, ako, masama ang mangyayari kay Doggy.
Pero ito na nga, 2v1 setup ang mangyayari. Si Chester, confident siya na isa lang nag-isa pero tamang tag. Ang ginawa nila, Yahweh with the Wave of the Dragon. Ito na nga, Chester will be panicked as well. Wala lang dito si Aeson to the rescue but that won't be possible because that's already a 3v1 situation. Lady Senorita, ang mamita natin, mapipilitan munang mag-back together with Wise, the VY setup, 2v2 situation tayo dito sa may middle lane. Pero tamang hinga lang muna, pero from the top, someone's about to drop his hat. At andun na nga, nag-quote na nga, oh, Mr. Shower, he's committed by
people.
Yun na nga, napatay na rin sa atasente. Pero Yawi,
naiwan pa si Esther.
Rescue to rin, nakakamu ang saligaw, magan ng very, very light. Pero Esther is up there to the rescue. 4v2 situation, talagang si Estes yung kanilang binabakbak.
Ako, delikado yung kalagay ni Renny J. There goes a takedown. Ate B, ang ganda ng ginawang sagot dito ng Blacklist International. Talaga sumasabay sila when Next Play Esports trying to pick off their members one by one. Ang sagot nila, hindi lang kayo yung kayang pumick off. Pinick off din nila rito si Renny J. Yes, na-pick off nila yung ating si Aeson, no? Pero may bawi agad. Talaga hindi nagpapatalo. And if you actually look at the gold lead ng Next Play Esports, hindi ganon kalaki. Objective-wise, pareho yung team natin na wala pang nakukuhang turret. Pero gold plating ang nakuha ng NXP onto the top lane. Deadly Blade na yung binedeta natin dito. Actually going for the Bloodless Acquisition. Esmeralda natin with the Enchanted Talisman. Whilst Alice with the Clock of Destiny. Lunox going for the Clock of Destiny as well. Whilst yung Chang'o natin, Necklace of Durance for that first item. Good item choice para sa isang support mage and actually trying to counter the entire enemy team almost. No, kasi lahat sila may shield and may heal. Pero
another difference bago happen sa turtle. Nagka-counteran na nga sila dito. Counteran pero mawag din ang pagsasan. Ito na yung turtle has been secured by Brody. Pero ito na may pumasok pa sa may bandang game.
bogey,
it as well, pero yun, ang ganda. I'm on top of the world talaga. Ang nangyari sa kanya, Jango was able to take down Venus right there. Pero eto na si H2O, nangangalmot pa dito ni Batang Getty at nakapatay pa nga ng isa. Pero eto na si Chester, pumasok na kahit nandun ay dalawa at patay na pa nga yung Brody. Pero hindi lang nag-iisa dahil Renji together with Edward, nagpabakbakan pa. Yung Jango, binalikan pa nung Alice, dumobol kill pa nga. And that was a trade of 4-2.
Actually, 4-3. 4-3 teams dito ng Blacklist International. Masyadong nag-overstay. If away nung medyo nakakalamang na sila, hindi nasali sila na pick off ni H2O. Nakadalawa pa yung Brody natin with the torn apart memory securing a kill, and when they tried to dive him onto the turret, kamuntikanan pa si Chester. Luckily, Lady Luck is on her side, pero onto the top lane, Chester against Doggy, pero Yawi onto the bush is actually waiting for the perfect opportunity para masetapan ang isang Alice. At TV, ito na nga ata.
Ito na nga, gugustuhin talaga na lang setapan dahil hindi lang si Yawi, andito yung buong repa. Ito na, Blood of the Stream committed as well. Samantalang si Iso, nag-flicker out na nga just to disengage. At yun na nga, early triggering that healing galing coming from Estes. Ang galing, Baymax. It's been 6 minutes and 30 seconds already. As early as now, kanino, may nakikita ka na ba? May nasisilip ka na ba kung kaninong momento? Kasi kung ako, nagsisiso lang eh.
Actually, yung momentum dito, salita lang talaga yung magkabilang team. Not unless magkaroon tayo ng isang pick-off or with a team fight. Team fight pick-off, hindi yung mag-isang pick-off. Tulad nito, onto na middle lane. Blacklist International trying to be aggressive right now. Sinasabayan talaga nila yung next play eSports. Pero Edward yata on the bottom lane ang mamamatahan. 7 minutes into game. Wala pa tayong turret takedown. Cutting lane si Benedetta on the top side. That is a very good decision. Pero Turtle is now up for grabs and is waiting to be taken. This is going to be the third Turtle of the game, and positioning wise maganda ang Next Play Esports kasi halos lahat sila malapit ang miyembro.
Oo, talagang nagko-commit silang all-in. Samantalang SN dito, nagpo-provide lang ng enough vision and mission. Samantalang dito nga si Chester, tinawag ng mga ref at eto nga,
Word 4-5
na ang mangyayari. Pero uy, walit ka ni Yes, did connect. Pero eto nga, nakapagpaka na sila ng init. Samantalang look at the Benedetta, andun na ng final flag to blow. Pero nakapitas na nga sila ng dalawa dito. Oh no, ang nangyayari, si Wise nandito na sa may bedlang Getty together with Mumsy na naghihil lang. Pero Winter Transon has been committed as well. But don't do that to Yawi dahil nakapitas na nga rin sila ng isa doon sa may bandang Getty. Pero eto na nga, 3v3 situation tayo. Rene J, mapipilitan muna mag-back kasi 0.5% na lang ang natira sa buhay niya. Samantalang si Doggy, hinahabol pa ni Edward, pero tamang disengage na lang sila muna.
Sabi, alam mo ba, itong heroes ng Blacklist International may sustain, tapos scaling dapat scaling to ng late game. Pero this early on to the game, tignan mo yung score, 1-0-3 for the Esmeralda, Chester 4-2-3, while si Wise 3-1-4. Hindi na nila kailangan mag-scale sa late game kasi as of now, they're currently scaling the game. And if you look at the item of the Bruno dito, with that Berserker's Fury going for the endless battle, Calamity Reaper, Enchanted Talisman to Esmeralda natin, meron ng Winter Transon, ang agang nag-grow as a player nung ating Alice. Well, sa kabilang side, Lunox dito going for the Lightning Truncheon. Brody, walang masyadong damage going for the Athena King. Benedetta though, going for the Immortality with that Bloodlust Axe. Look at this. On the bottom lane, si Renji yata magiging target.
Talagang mapapawaw ka dito, pero Order of Brilliance has been committed back to disengage. Pero eto na nga, oh no, dahil eto na yung hinahanap nating Tony.
Si Wise.
Dapat kanina pa napatumba, pero si
Wise,
pero ang sakit naman ng critical na yun, hindi siya napatumba, pero there you go, sabi mo, kanina ka pa. And that was a trade of 2-1, Baymax. Si Wise lang ang napitas dun sa Blacklist.
This is a bad exchange.
Sabi niya, hold on ito. Dahil nag-Way of the Dragon pa sa dito sa may bandang Getty. Tapos nag-reverse sweep na nga. Dahil si Doggy yung nakapitas doon sa may isa. At eto na nga, tamang disengage lang muna. And that is Benedetta. Very Benedetta yung ginagawa ni Doggy dito. No? In, out. So magkocommit siya. Tapos at the same time, bibitawan niya rin.
Yes, Ate B, still that was on the side of Blacklist International. Why? Ang nakuha nila rito is Hyper Carry. Though yes, nakuha nila si Wise ng Next Play Esports. No? Si Lancey yung sumunod, while sa other side, I think si Paquito, yung tank lang ang kanilang nakuha. Pero on the bottom lane, apat laban sa isa ang posibleng mangyari dito. From the picker out, makakatakas si Chester. I like the way na sinusubukan gayahin ng Next Play Esports ngayon dito, yung ginawa sa kanila ng Blacklist International. The imitation is real for the rotation para makabawi. Pero Iso, naganda ng abang niya rito ah, sa side ng Lord, because Lord is now up for grabs. Wala pa rin kumukuha as of now.
Actually, yun na nga, no, dito, these two teams, they know when to commit and when to not, Baymax. They are just providing enough vision and mission. Tingnan mo nga naman si Eson. Gantong-ganto yung ginawa niyo nung digis siya kanina. And ang maganda rin naman dito for Blackness International, look at the V-Wise connection. Hindi sila naglalayo. Pero ito yes. Na nga, mukhang may paglayo.
Uy, ako si Doggy, di makalayo.
Oo nga, may paglayo at paglingis. Way of the Dragon has been committed again by Yami. Pero season lang yung natamaan na dito. Samantalang si Nancy, popping out that meteor shower. It has been committed, but yes, hindi pa siya masyadong masakit. Si Eason lang yung sumalo lahat-lahat.
Yung commitment na binitawan dito ng Next Way Esports, masyadong maraming nasayang na skill. Para lang subukan pumitas ng tank tornado setup sa amin dito ang nadrapas ni Chester.
Pero ito na nga, Vlad. Oh, that's been committed as well. Pero ultimate din ang kinan pa. Pero oh, final electro blow. It did connect one to three. Killing sleep pa nga ang kuya mo doon.
Ay, so na naman yung target.
Ang ganda naman ang pakbaka nila dito. H2O nalusaw doon sa gitna. Samantala si Yawi matitirang doon sa may bandang baba. And that was a trade of 2-1.
2-1 pa, Ate Bino. 2-1 in favor of Blacklist International. And there goes the Lunok side lane and the Bruno hyper carry. Pero hindi pa tapos yata dito. Naku, another ba yung mga kanan naman?
Uy, nag-falling sermon nga doon kay Doggy. Pero ito na nga, because of that open possibility, opportunity, they are grabbing this Blacklist International. Binabakbakan na nga yung Lord. Hindi na inantay pa maging jumping Jolox Lord to. Dahil napatay na nga nila, samantalang Doggy, finally down to business dahil babalik lang siya kung saan siya nag-umpisa. At dito yung sa taas, talagang hindi nila pinapabayaan na mabasag tong outer target nila sa taas.
Yes, dito na natin mararamdaman yung objective ng Blacklist International. With the help of the Lord, they could possibly take down 2-3 turrets sa base ng Next Bay Esports. Since nga, lalo na ngayon, nawala ng meteor shower, si Lance dito on trying to take down the Lord. The Lord is marching in onto middle lane. Another teamfight might happen with Eason marching in onto back lanes, pero hindi. Ito na, 12 minutes into game, 4 turret takedown para sa side ng Blacklist International. Isasama pa ata yung inhibitor turret.
Uy, pero yun, may natadyakan kaso na pa sa mga panga dahil pinasok mo yan, lima sila eh. Together with the healing jelly and virtue na meron dito si Monkey Renegades, binapapakan nga dito. Without that meteor shower, it won't be possible. Samantalang si Doggy lumabas ng bandang Gately, pero tamang mamba out lang din dito siya sa may down bottom as they're just going to secure and clear the minion base. Pero eto na nga, on to the top.
On to the top?
Another setup is about to happen.
Alis! Ayun na!
Center for three! Inultihan ng tatlo. Matala si Doggy, mamintas yung sa may bed ng Getty. Pero Winter Truncheon and growing as a player ang ginawa lang ni Chester. And tamang disengage lang sila muna as the minion will keep on coming para sa side ng Next Play Esports.
Yes, guys, no, ang comeback potential na lang talaga dito ng Next Play Esports is for Brody to find a really good position when it comes to teamfight and baka kuha siya ng isang damage item. And for Doggy, si Doggy actually maganda na eh. Yung mga ginagawa niya, mga electro final blow niya, yung setup niya, connecting onto the enemy team. But it is not enough na siya lang yung nagdi-dish out ng ganong kataas na damage. Yes, they have the Lunox, pero Lunox is one of the very first targets ng Blacklist International kapag nagkakaroon tayo ng teamfight. They really know. Alam kasi nila kung sino yung possible na makapunit or makapatay agad dun sa kanilang Bruno. This just proves us kung gano'ng kataas yung communication skills ng Blacklist International dito. So, ang ano nga eh, feeling ko, nararamdaman ko, Tenet, sa isip ko, ang pinag-uusapan nila, protect mo ko, sabi ni Wise, huwag niyong padikitin sa akin yung Lunox at yung Benedetta. Kaya talagang hindi siya hinihiwalayan ni Venus on every team fight. Healing galing, ambulansya is real, Ate B.
Talagang walang hiwala. Yan yung ngayon talagang tinatawag natin the V-Wise Connection Israel. Plus, do not forget the fact na nandyan din si Chester for the backup, diba? For a good setup. And he was able to do that.
Ang ganda ng ginagawa lang talaga ni Estes para sa akin. Alam mo yung protection bago umaksyon para dun sa kanilang Bruno. Pero eto, another setup might happen. Si Yawi na naman ang mahuhuli ng Falling Starborn.
Falling Starborn, it did connect to Yawi. Pero Yawi would be able to turn back muna para mag-rejoin. Pero
oh
it was the Brody. What a catastrophe dahil yung Brody yung napitas.
Kanina
sila. Sino na nga ba yung mag-aangas? Plus another one dahil napatay na rin si Rene J. Napabuo na lang siya dahil finally na-slay. Anong nangyari doon?
Ay nako, ang nangyari doon is nagkaroon sila ng extension sa kanilang lanes. Dapat hindi sila masyadong uma-advance. Masyado silang napa-advance, they actually forgot na yung map control wala sa side nila and is on the side of Blacklist Internet. Hindi nyo mahirap eh pag wala kayong map control, hindi nyo alam kung saan lalabas ako laban, pero ito lalabas sa lahat ng buhay.
Pero ito has it like no one is under the control of Planet Israel. Ang sakit, and yun na nga, dito na nga magtatapos, it is beyond their control dahil Blacklist International would be the one to secure our series number 2.
Ang laking bagay na yung mga scaling heroes dito ng Blacklist International eh maagang nang ano, maagang nagka-item, maagang nag-scale tulad ng nabanggit ko kanina, no. The Bruno, ang aga nung kanyang Berserker's Fury, yung Alice, syempre with the Winter Truncheon, I think 8 minutes, 7 minutes pa lang ata, a Clock of Destiny Winter Truncheon na kagad. Yung Alice natin, no, while yung Esmeralda